Hello everyone and welcome back to Eve Market, your weekly look at the MMR market. Second try for me for the recording because apparently my PC decided to lock up. But those are already on the market here, 1.7, 2.2 billion ISK here on the market. Asbels will take a few more days before they pop up on the market. And after Sotio, it's gonna probably not even show up here, but Rataus already have seen them deployed in perimeter. They're like I think 4 or 5 or something deployed there already. I think they're all by one corp that deployed them there. Only one is what I saw is equipped with a manufacturing plant, but those are the first one I saw pop up just perimeter because I passed through there. I saw that, but we're here for the market. Let's go straight for Tritanium, where we're on for. I will see a little bad data here. Try to fix this a little bit by mouse scrolling. There we go. We see a few spikes on the Tritanium here and here. Not really much interesting. A few spikes on prices here towards the 6 ISK. That's only 5. But on average, we're still pretty much sitting at the same price. We see only a very slight uptrend in the 20-day. The 5-day average is pretty much sitting on the same line. So surprisingly, it's not really doing a lot at the moment on the price. Pretty stable still, even with the new expansion out. 6.23 for the sellers and 5.65 for the buyers. And it's even slightly lower than last week. 5.80 was the last week's price. So we have even still on the Tritanium on the buyer side. A small drop on that. Then let's see what ferrite is doing. Looks like all of them has a bit of a wrong data point. Let's see, here we go, ferrite. 20 day average still dropping. We see also here at the same days the spikes on sales on ferrite. The 5-day average has definitely been going down until about the Tuesday, indeed, when patch came out. After that, we can clearly see ferrite is definitely starting to go up in price. Easily in the 8 ISK. Except for here for the last 2 days from yesterday and today, we seem to be already getting a slight drop again on the price for ferrite. So, quick uptrend, a little bit on the price. After that, we've seen again a small drop in the price even. So this had some impact, but not too much. We'll see more on the price, what is going. 9.17 for the sellers and 8.03 for the buyers. So that went definitely up. 7.96 was last week's price. So definitely went slightly up in the price for ferrite. It's not a lot really on that. Oh, by the way, this is, I typed in wrong, by the way. Never mind. I typed in an additional zero. Then we go on for Maxilon. Let's see what Maxilon doing. Wow, they really all of us have this bad point. Wow, there we go. Let's quick look at this, because I see a high price of 9, almost 10,000 for Maxilon Alpha clones, and the lowest is like 42. I don't know what they're doing with buying, but they're definitely in a making some mess of it. But Maxilon has not really any effect either here. We see also big have more sales on the same days as the rest of them. Started to not even drop or anything. The 20-day average is staying pretty much on the same line. 5-day pretty much has done the same thing. It even dropped in price on the day that that the complexes came out. It dropped down to that point, a little bit the lowest point for this whole month. And after that, it starts only slightly going up, but then making a drop again. Only for today, it seems to be going up again. Too early for the average price, but already starting to go back. I'm pretty sure this is going to go back down again. If we can look at this later on the day, But yeah, not really any movement here on the Maxilon. It's even going down, it looks like, on price. 69.49 for the sellers and 63.27 for the buyers. That definitely went up in price for the buyers. 62.59 was last week's price. So Maxilon is definitely starting to go up in price. It doesn't say really on the graph, but on the buyer side, we're definitely going up on that. Wondering what Isogen is gonna do, because that one did hit record bottom prices last week, and it looks like we're gonna have that also this week. Isogen had no effect at all with the new complex came out. It came out on this day, where the price even dropped more, even the day after that it dropped more. On the 17th, it went slightly up. We see only a slight increase here. Here in price on the Friday, we even dropped again. It was about 68. And for yesterday, 69, today, 70. So it looks like we're getting a slight increase in Isogen. It is not really a lot at the moment that's increasing. But it is going up on that shut up phone. It is slightly increased, but I don't know if it's really gonna keep on going on that. We may see more minerals coming on the market. We'll see more next week what it's gonna do. 72 is for the sellers, but that's only not too much, so you get really quick to the 72.92 is for the oxygen on the sellers. For the buys, 67.36 on that. That is it is a slight drop again on price for this. 67.52 was last week's price, so it didn't drop too quickly on that. So it means we have again a new record bottom price for Isogen here on the market on the buyer side. So again, a drop on price here, but not really a huge amount that I can say it's gonna be worth. Expecting it to drop more now. There's this chance that probably more buyers gonna come in now because it is really low. Because it's really starting to slow down on the drop. And we can see the clear see in the graph already here slightly an upgoing price. So we may hit the bottom price for the Isogen. Noxium. Also here, not really in effect. We definitely see here, biggest sales on Noxium here for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 days. It started already before the complexes came out. That's on the 12th what he started. That's even before last week. We see a little bit bigger sales on Noxium for all these days. After that, it's starting to slow down again. Price seems to be really stable. Even the 5-day doesn't really seem to move. Only really small amounts make. Make it look a little bit better at it there. See, it doesn't really move anymore. Only here on this day, today, slightly uptrend, but too early. 20 day, of course, is still dropping. It's getting dark here suddenly. It's still dropping that 20 day average. A little bit high prices here. 393, 391, but you see already here dropping again to 381. Not really huge movements in here. 407.98 for the sellers and 376.53 for the buyers. That did went up in price. Surprising. Doesn't really see in the graph, but it is going up in price. 367.27 was last week's price, so it definitely started to go a little bit up, but not really a huge amount, if I say, but it is getting a small increase. I'm not sure if this gonna keep on pushing up really on here on that price. Now gonna also a few interesting ones on for the Zynoid and the Mega side, because there last week there were one isk difference from each other. Mega side was one isk more higher on price than Zynoid. It's gonna be really interesting what this is gonna do. I see Zynoid at least still dropping in price. Pretty decent sales here on the 17. On the price that was on looks like the first day. Also here we can clearly see a huge drop in price to 925, average price for that day for Zendert. But then next day it coming back up to 981, 984 for the Saturday. Today we're seeing at 976 on the average price. But let's see on the 5-day and the 20-day average, we are still dropping in price for Zendert. It's still going down. Seller's price 984, and for the buyers 932 on that. So it's definitely a drop. 985 was last week's price, so it's still clearly dropping in price here. And it's also really interesting, what is Megasite doing? Need to fix the graph here. There we go. Megasite, really interesting. Maybe people thought it is low, let's buy in here. Because we have suddenly a lot of movement in here. But last week, pretty stable prices here, pretty low prices. Last week's was around there. Last week's price was here, so that was that one. It came still on that day an average price of 1015 out on that price. Last week's video. Day after that, we make a little bit drop on the Monday. We can clearly see here that is on the 16th. No, last week was here. I think it was the 20s today. Let's see, yeah, here came the complexes out on the 15th. This is the Monday, that was the last week's price, 1000. That's the day where the complexes came out. That's on 99 on that day. But clearly see the day after that, we see a big spike on the price for Megasite to almost 1200 on the price. But you see it next day. Straight away back down to 1020. Then again, and we're going up to 1188 on the price, and straight away back down here. A big sales hit, by the way, on the Saturday, yesterday, on that 5.6 million units being sold, with normally about 1.4, 2.9 million units. Also for today, we're seeing already pretty high average price, 1150 on Megasite. We can clearly see Megasite did hit its bottom point here in the market and starting to go up in price. 1179.25 for the sellers, 1015 for the buyers. 986 was last week's price. We definitely see here the price increasing on that. Yeah, just hit its bottom point that people are buying it in. Then more fight. Let's see what Morphite is doing. Let's see if we can move this one a little bit. There. Morphite, not really any movement. We see definitely here a little bit high price during the middle of the week. Sitting around the 8,889. Sitting a little bit around that. Pretty high in the 8,000s. And already here on the Saturday we dropped again to 8,312. Today is in at the moment 8,350. Well, I've already put in a normal sales already for today. So we've probably seen a pretty big amount being sold today. So it's not really anything interesting. It's like buyers, sellers here. Not really any interesting movement on the Morphite part. Pretty big amount here coming in at 8,889 on that. And we're sending about 8,000 for the buyer's price. That went down. 8,316 was last week's price, so Morphite is still dropping in price on that. Let's look at some regular salvage. Let's see what this is doing. Armor plates still on the drop. 520 day, clearly 20 day also starting to kick in on the drop again. We're dropping in price. It's been pretty stable for the last 3 days, sitting at 37,780 on that. 1 day a little bit hit lower here at 35,000 per unit, but looks pretty stable. Is really making steps down all the time. You see sitting here around 44,000 pretty all the time, and with small drops, and then suddenly making another drop and staying pretty much around that. So maybe staying again for a few days pretty much on this price and making another step down. But the prices for armor plates are still dropping. 44,798 for the sellers, that's more than 500 units, in this case exactly 500 units. But we see already orders coming in at like high 38,000s, low 39, high 38s. On that, also for the buyers, we're sitting at 38,338. That's again lower than last week's, was last week's price 42,250. On that, so armor plates still dropping, and again a new record bottom price on the armor plates. On that, we had a record price last week, we have now a record bottom price this week. Plates are keep dropping. I don't know, is this because there's so much on the market, or people just don't use it anymore? Market is a little bit slow. Alright, burn logic circuits. Burn logic circuits definitely still increasing in price. You can clearly see here we're starting to make a quick up in price. The day that the complexes came out, see 2 days sitting at 64,000 per unit. Then we're going up to 70,000 per unit, already making a little bit of a drop here today to 66. Clearly increase in sales for that, which you need it for the rigs. So it's definitely pushing the price up for a few days only, and then we're making a drop. Sales amount on the 16, about 110,000, 96,000 on the 17, 85,000 and a half on the 18, we're slowly making drop 84,000 plus on the 19. Today we're pretty low on sales. The sales are slowly dropping, the highest on the 16 and slowly dropping, so expect this price to start dropping also on that. More than 500 units a bit far away, because we're heading out to 72,900 is for that on the sellers, that's more than 500 units, and for the buyers it's 67,000, just above that for the buyers. That's clearly a push up on price. 59,250 was last week's price, so we're making suddenly a big jump up on the price here for burn logic service. We are getting really quickly close at a record high price on this. We are like now 2,000 off the record high price. So burn logic circuits really quickly increasing in price because of this. Fried interface circuits, same story. Sales amount have been increasing here, definitely starting from the 16 after the complexes coming out. A lot of sales here on the 19, about 200,000 on one day. It's pretty a lot. Price is definitely being pushed up. We're sitting a little bit lower for today, but we're sitting at 5,300 currently on the price for fried interface circuits. They're really pushing up quite quickly here on the price. I think this one is going to keep on going even more on the next week. Maybe in the middle of the week starting to stabilize, or maybe start dropping again. 7,060 for the sellers. 4,750 for the buyers. That's definitely an increase on that. 4,025 was last week's price. We see pretty decent quick increase here on the prices. And also here we are not too far off a record high price for it. Record high price sitting at 5,500. So we are like 750 off that. If you're gonna reach it, yeah, doubt it. Melted capacitor consoles, also these are making quite rapidly up. I see high price here of about 15,000 apparently. Highest price 13,600, 11,000, 14,400. Really high prices on there. So here quickly starting to increase in price. Definitely on the day of the patch we had a big higher average price than normal. Days after that we dropped again towards the 7,000. Oh, we're sitting here at 10,700 on the average price. We can clearly see the days after that we are going back up to the 11,000 per unit for melt capacitors. Quite quick increase. You see also the sales doubling, tripling the amount is normal. Takes the normal one is about 10,000 per unit. At the highest here we're sitting about 44,000 per unit sold on one day. That's like 4.5 times more than normal on the sales on multi-capacitor consoles. So quick increase on this price. If you have a load, it's gonna be really interesting to sell it. Not too much on the market. We are pretty short here still on the market. 13,600 for the sellers, 11,000 for the buyers. On that, definitely an increase. 7,000 was last week's price at least. We're now at 11,000, and this is again for multi-capacitor consoles. It's a record top price. Top price was at 9,750. So we have new record top prices for multi-capacitor consoles. On this, I may have a few lying around. I don't know. I think I used it all up already. This also means that can have effect on rigs that they starting to go up in price a few. Trip power circuits already seen. Seeing indeed some increase, it was already going up like 2 weeks ago. It's starting to go up in price. After that, it did make a drop again to 13,000, but after that, it's starting to go up again on the price. It's really steadily going up, not like a big increase like multi-capacitor consoles. That's the only one that's making a really big increase. The rest is staying pretty steady increase on price. I expect more movement in here, but we have a few others we're gonna look at to see what those are doing. This one is just steadily going up. We see here for the Saturday and Friday a little bit higher sales at about 15,100 per unit. Today we're sitting back to 14,080 per unit on average at the moment. But also here we're still increasing in price. More than 500 units, 16,200 for the sellers and 14,100 for the buyers. Also here we're going up in price. 13,000 was last week's price. So we see here increase, not even close getting record high prices here. Then Plex, it's gonna be interesting what Plex is gonna do. Plex is making a quite of a big drop in price. It's starting only here on the 18th. Complexes came out on the 15th. Looks already people starting to sell some more Plexes, getting the money in for the complexes. And we see a quite rapid drop here. At least for the last 3 days, making a pretty big drop on the price for Plexus. Sales amount not changed at all. Could be of the new Alpha clones back on the server. I did saw on the first day after Complexus came out in the evening, it was like 35,000 people online. I haven't seen that many people online for a while. So definitely more players seems to be getting in there. Or maybe people just going back that stopped playing Eve and coming back again. So Plex definitely making a drop in price on here. Let's see what the prices are. 1,147,000,000, 47.2 million is for the sellers, and for the buyers 1,030,000,000 on the price. That's definitely a nice drop. We're getting close to dropping below the billion ISK again for Plex. Last week's price was 1,197,000,000. So definitely a nice drop here on the price for Plex. That was the normal look what you have to today. Let's look at some other stuff that is being used for the complex rigs. Broken drone transceivers. We definitely seen an increase. This was already before it. And huge sales amount, like I don't know, way more than normal. Complexes came out here on the 15th. You see straight away more sales on broken drone transceivers and a big increase in price on this. We're sitting currently about 11,000 for it. The price we're coming from 5,000. We see easily the price already doubled for the broken drone transceivers on this. So really quick increase on that. Take a look at the prices. Not too many on the market, definitely in a shortage. Definitely some more people want to buy these things in. So definitely the effect on that, since we definitely made these ones more worth it now at the moment. Charge microcircuits, same story. We can definitely see here a big increase. Only started on the 17th, but 2 days after the complexes came out, so that's a little bit slower on the response. But it's definitely seen here more sales, about 700,000 here on one day, 250,000 on the next day, another the same on the day after that on the 19th. So definitely big increases here. We see also the price on those 3 days that we had more sales, also higher prices for that. It's at 989 and 1,000 for those sales. I can see today we have not reached even a normal amount. You see straight away the price dropping again towards 692 at the moment on an average price. So also here quickly starting to make some drops in the prices on that. Still there is a lot on the market here. See here there's 1.4 million units on the market at 1600. So that's why probably the price is dropping. Because we see here the high price, people think let's put it on the market, and that's pushing straight away the price down. Conductive polymer. Also here a slight response on it. We definitely see some days with more sales. Starting from the 15 on the patch day, 16 some more on the 17, again more. So also a little bit a late response here on that. Also here definitely prices are increasing. We already see some more increased prices here and there on certain days. And then I think people are set up a certain point to what price they bought all this these in. But I'm surprised the direction is not too bad. 8,200 was yesterday's average price. 8,000 on a Friday. Today is still sitting at 7,500 on average price. So also here definitely a good increase in price. Stuff getting more worth it on that. But this is just gonna be all short amount of spikes until all the rigs are produced and people have the money back in. These prices will start dropping again. So also clearly increasing in price. Let's see how the market is doing. It looks pretty balanced. There's a 250,000 units on sales that someone want to buy here. So this making a little bit of a short is still here on the market. Sitting about 8,200 currently for the sellers and 6,500 for the buyers on the conductive polymer. Contaminated Lorentz fluid. Also here, really a big increase in price. Sales amount, I'm surprised it's not really too high. It's maybe because there's like hardly any of this on the market here, but the price is rapidly going up here. But it's already lower today towards 54,000, 54,800 ISK for the today's average price. This one is already making a drop down on the price with a really quick increase here. We came on the highest here on the 18 for the price, about 100,000 per unit. That's really high. If you see it, beginning of the month was sitting at 12,000, so it was a big increase, like 10 times more from the beginning of the month on price. But you can clearly see already here on the Saturday we start making a drop to back to the 80,000, and like I said today already dropping to 54,800 ISK for that. So also making quick drops back down again. We'll see it dropping more on the next week. There are some orders up, not a huge amount, 69,000, 65,000. There's only 24 units, can be gone quite quickly. For the buyer sitting at 22,000 at the moment. Contaminated nanite compound. Also here, clearly increase in price. Already seeing here for today a drop, it's too early for that. Sales amount already starting to increase on the 11th. So that's like 4 days before the patch came out. Patch day was right here. It was the lowest sale on that because we have a longer downtime. We can see also here more sales and really late response, by the way, because only here on the Saturday yesterday we had a bigger amount of sales than compared to the whole month. So really late response on the nanite compound on that for it's going up. Prices, we're heading for the 94,500 per unit here and 94,000 on the Friday. So price increasing quickly already today. We're sitting lower again, 41,800 on that, but that can all change still. So we see here also really quick increase in price. Not a lot on the market. There is about Even calculate quickly. 1400 on the market on units. That's really low amount, because all these together is already less than the first buyer here. So prices are probably going to increase quite quickly here if there's not more coming on the market. Sitting currently at about 40,000 per unit. But it's a pretty high price seeing where we're coming from. So it's like double the price. Damage artificial network. Also this one is really quickly going up. Also really late response on the sales. Big sales here yesterday. Half a million units, just over half a million units from the normal price on the day before that. There's only about 130,000 being sold. So someone definitely bought in a whole load of that, or sold a whole load at 2,500 per unit. Also here, definitely a big increase, because we came in beginning of the month from 600. Also here, really quick increase in the price. Sales already started a day before the patch, and on the 14th, we see already increase in sales during the whole week, more sales on that. Especially Saturday popped out really hard on the sales here. It's pushing definitely the price hard up. Still, there are pretty decent size orders up on the market. Buyers not really going up. There are a few big orders up here, 2,500 per unit. While selling at 3,749. That is looks like pretty even on supply. I think there's a little bit more supply, but we're heading towards the 10,000 for that already. On that, we see definitely a few more newer orders coming in here too. Defective current pump always been really, really low. Also, there's definitely more sales on that, but the response on the price is a little bit slower. On the 17, we still see a pretty normal price of 1,000 on that. It's only 300 higher than the beginning of the month. Sales amounts already started on the 12, going up. So that's quite early that the sales went up. On the 15 went up, 16 pretty normal sales. Between the before and after the patch day, we see a normal price sales on that. But after that, we're definitely seeing an increase in price and sales amount, and the price went really late up. It started only on the 18 that the price started to go up. That was on a Friday. We see suddenly spiked to 5,900. But the Saturday where they pulled back to 2,101 on the price. But for the today, we're already going back up to 3,880 on the price. Also here, clearly starting quick an increase. Still, there are pretty decent size orders up here for 7,700 on that 50,000 units, but on I think on a medium size rig, it's like only for enough for one rig. On that, I'm not even sure. I haven't put these things in my spreadsheet on that. But clearly, a few big size orders up here. Buyers price about 1600 on that. So clearly, there's not too much on the market, and we see definitely price going up. This can have a little bit a longer term effect, because its response is so slow. Scores telemetry processor, also here clearly increase in price, really high increase here, 18,000, almost 19,000 per unit. While we're coming on the early month from 2,500 per unit, so that's a really big increase in price. But that's only on the Friday. Saturday, sorry. On the first Friday, it was about 13,300 on that. But see why the price today is here. On the average price, 7,876 at the moment. Sales amount started already on the 13th, going up. The days after that, not really any effect. Starting to go slightly up on the patch day. And then the next 3 days, definitely seen an increase, but after that, it stopped already on the sales amount and going back towards pretty much a normal amount. So this also probably gonna push, gonna get the price down again, and that's why we're sitting lower for today's average price already. Supply on the market is not too big. For the sellers, we're sitting at 14,000 per unit. That's a good size order up here for just below the 20,000 per unit. So that prices are still be possible to going up. On the buyers, we're sitting at 10,000 per unit at the moment. So clearly a good increase on price. Well, the average price is sitting around the 7,876 at the moment. Smash trigger units. Huge price on the Saturday. I was saying Friday, but it's the Saturday. Clearly increased there. On that, it's already making a drop 4,784 for days, but the sales amount is not even visible. Sales amount are not really that high. It is easily more than normal. See, 150,000, well, normal amount is like 10,000, so that's still a big increase. You don't see it really, like, those bars are not too high. But definitely, sales are increasing pretty a lot here. Also, already starting here on the 12th and the 13th. The 14th was pretty quiet on the sales. On patch day, definitely more sales. The days after that, all more sales for all days. So that's definitely making a nice push up on the price. Highest price we see now is 6,496 on the average. Some decent size orders coming in here. Both come in today. So 50,000, 28,000 on the units, 6,249 on the price. On the buying at 3,000 at the moment. We'll take a look at Tangle Power Conduits. We definitely see more response here. We saw an increase in price here on the 8th this month. So there's a really early response on it. The 15 is right here. So the day before the patch and the day on the patch, we had a normal sales amount. Before that, on the 13th and the 12th, we had more and bigger sales on that. And definitely on the 16th, 17th, and the 18th, and the 19th, we've seen an increased sales amount and pushing the price pretty rapidly up, because we came at the 18th at 12,000 per unit on average that day. See already on the Saturday we made another drop to 8,300 because the sales dropped pretty rapidly down. At least half of it than normal. This day had about 110,000 per units sold. About just under 36,000 on the 19th, the day after that. So that's definitely a quick drop on sales amount. So looks like we're gonna go pretty quickly back to a normal sales amount on this. All people thinking the price is currently too high, we're waiting till more coming up on the market and just buy all that up. There's 47,000 units coming in here on the top from today at 15,849. There's a big buyer up here for 8,250 per unit on price. He wants a whole load of it. 86,500 units he wants. That's a big order here. And also a pretty high price for that. Twas consoles. One that has the less response on the price. It's expecting this one to respond a lot more on price. It's like only doubled about the price. Not even doubled. Except for this day. That is the patch day. Price got pushed up to 21,000 per unit. Well, it came the day before that from 3,500 on average that day. So on patch day it pushed up really high on price. We still see the line sitting there. So most stuff is on the buy. Sales amount not really too much of an increase. 8,000 per unit, 8,000 units that day. About 40,000 units on this day. So it's still a pretty good increase on that on price. On sales amount, price, we'll see a bit. Biggest sales on the 18, about 100,000 units on that day, but already completely dropping in again. Only this day, on the 15, we see a huge price increase on that. Still, seller's price sitting around the 15,000 per unit, buyers sitting 6,250. So let's see, these are sitting at the 6,250, so most of the stuff is getting sold straight away towards the buyers. So this was this week's look at the MR market. Really interesting, a lot of salvage are increasing in price except for the armor plates that we have seen. That's the only one that has gone down in price still. And it's getting really, really low on price for the armor plates. Gonna be really interesting to buy a load in of that. So, thanks for watching. I will see you all next week. It's gonna be, again, pretty interesting what most of the salvage is gonna do. It's gonna stop balancing out or going back to its normal price. So, see you all next week and fly safe.